So hush, pretty baby, don't you cry, don't you cry, don't you cry.
Definitely in the air, the fact that a cappella needed to have a rhythmic underpinning. In fact, the Nylons were out there performing on the road through the late 80s with a drum machine. And when you would hear groups like Sweet Honey and the Rock, they would perform with shakers. Pop music had become so rhythmically driven that traditional a cappella, without any kind of something to give a rhythmic drive, sounded retro. It sounded street corner and doo-wop or barbershop or classical. So something needed to get put in there, particularly if you were going to do really young, energetic modern music. But honestly, what I was doing was not only integrating vocal percussion, it was integrating vocal horns and vocal guitar lines, and also finding a new vocabulary of how do you use your voice syllabically, rhythmically, to create a fullness and layers of sound so that this a cappella was able to stand up side by side with modern popular music. My first ever a cappella arrangement was actually in high school. It was a Beatles song, When I'm 64. And by the time I graduated high school, I had done a lot of male four-part arranging. In fact, won a big Bay Area-wide arts festival with an arrangement I did of Bohemian Rhapsody. My first piece of published music actually came as a result of me seeing so many groups out there singing the same songs, just as I noticed in college. The professional world, the Harmony Sweepstakes competitors, groups you would hear at a festival, they were singing again, Blue Moon and The Lion Sleeps Tonight, and It's Just Hard to Say Goodbye to Yesterday. And all these groups were either having to kind of transcribe it on their own or share these arrangements and exert a lot of energy in trying to get these songs into their repertoire. I was like, I need to publish these songs in standard format so people can pick them up, learn them, and move on so they can all start to develop their own style so we can have a rich, varied, community of a cappella groups. I ended up finding a small music publishing house in Texas called Voices Music Publishing that did mostly religious music. It's very small in-house, and I got them to agree to create the first two contemporary a cappella songbooks with all those kind of classic songs that I mentioned. Primarily a cappella said, well, I'll buy out their share and let's start a new publishing company, Contemporary A Cappella Publishing. So we did that and contacted Hal Leonard. And Hal Leonard at first was a little, I have to say they were a little suspicious. They weren't so comfortable giving us the rights to these songs because we were selling too many. We kept saying like, now can we get the rights to make, you know, another X thousand? And they were like, okay, and then another. And they were like, I don't know about that. And then finally they came back to us and said, how about if we do all of your printing, all of your distributing, you basically become a part of our family. And, you know, to be the iced tea at the bottom of the Coca-Cola machine, totally fine with me. We were off to the races, but we could only do songbooks. We were kind of held to it. And then they let us do 5 songs as opposed to 10 songbooks, and then 3 songs, and then okay, octavas, but a couple a year. Everything that I would put out would be gobbled up because this was an entire rapidly growing community of musicians for whom almost nothing existed published that they could sing. I realized I need to just go change culture. I need to go and make this a thing in the world, and then people at ACDA, people in the music publishing world, whatever, would start to take this more seriously. And when I graduated, there were 225 collegiate a cappella groups. Now there are over 3,000. There are probably more groups that are doing it than there are collegiate a cappella groups. And the middle school thing is taking off. Pro groups, there are gobs of them, particularly because of shows like The Sing-Off that gave us an opportunity to create groups. And then there are lots of community groups out there. So it was already in my blood that I wanted to be pushing the boundaries and doing the kinds of vocal music that nobody thought really could be done.